just as you go through the archway, you take about 10 steps, and on your left, about four or five different containers. I really like this one. I'm not really sure. Maybe it's a price point. Maybe people just don't visualize it finished. But nice set of candles. But if we had a large bowl of candles to set off on the top, this is the container itself, the bowl and the stand. Okay? And then this candle comes up from the center of that. It's all one piece. So all you have to do is surround it with foam and then make your arrangement. How much easier can it be? Very well done. Just something that, you know, getting a candle into a space that really don't have that opportunity, right? It doesn't really work. And here, the nice thing in today's economy or world, it's got the covered glass for the candle so it's protected, which I think a lot of the halls, that's what they're looking for in restaurants, is a protected flame. Very well done. And if you're interested in them, they're right outside the hall. I don't know why they keep making stuff, because I still got so much stuff in the back I'm trying to get out. So. Aren't these beautiful? David has a great way of using that cage and capture look to design sometimes. I love that. He's taken the sphere, cut it out, mounted it to the top of the container. But before he did that, he added in the roses. And then after he mounted the sphere with the roping, again, all the different textures, right? You have the grapevine, you have the roping, you have the silk flowers, you have the textured ceramic finish. All that works for today's ride. And then he finishes it off with the mini galas surrounding the arrangement altogether. Another quick reminder, these will all be on our Facebook page, our fan page, and the videos will be up in a couple of weeks. Beautiful design here. I love this mirror. It's almost a mirror, perfect glass type of finish. There's a little bit of the wire controlling, and that's why it looks that way. And some mini cows, always popular minis. And a little bit of sedum, it looks like sedum tucked here in the base of the arrangement. Again, giving us different looks for a table. This is really neat flowering branches. We have it in the white, David's used it in white, and then the pink you saw earlier. The same type of base vessel that we've used here, just a smaller size. So you could do two different looks on one table, or separate them however you want. This one, you think we're glued everything in, right? This paper here is from our friends at Accent Decor. And see what they've done is they've added a little bit of that beaded glitter to it. Just something a little bit different. When you're out there on the floor, you'll see the tables that we've set up for our designs today. They have some of this paper runner out there so you can see it and see how it looks on the table. We have a few different colors, correct? And I think it really works well. But David's used it as an accent to this. What a beautiful collar, right? Almost looks like a couple of fans. And then this arrangement, both the containers you can see, and that same metallic finish. Hydrangeas, the hydrangea and the container, two similar components in each. But then we just dressed each one up and finished it a little bit different. I like those. You like those? Okay. I'll take a switch here. I'm going to go to a bouquet. David's on this bouquet. I'm with white dahlias, white mini calas. It's beautiful. This is a great silk green. It's a real tall on a branch. A lot of our customers are buying it, putting it in tall vases, just as a loose branch. David has used it, but then cut it apart. I think the bright green, it's kind of a soft texture to it, really lends itself well to the bridal look. And then he's added, of course, a couple more hearts, a couple of silver hearts to go with it, because the bride loves the bling, right? She's going down the aisle, and she's looking at her bouquet because she's nervous. She doesn't want to look up. She's going to look, and you want her to see something, something to capture her attention. Those would do it, right? So when she's looking, she says, oh, okay. And she kind of focuses on that. Doesn't even matter what the rest of the bouquet looks like. She focuses there. And the reason I bring that up is sometimes maybe we get a little lazy and we don't finish the back of the bouquet. So when the bride's going down the aisle for 150 feet, she's thinking, this thing isn't even finished and it costs me $100 and it's not even finished in the back, okay? So finish it all the way around and then add something. She goes, wow, for $100 and I got diamonds. That's a good deal, right? Isn't that a change as well? And then this beautiful, David used the Fitz Design pearl waist or wristband. Boy, say that three times fast after an hour of talking. Look at the beautiful diamonds. These are it's just a little branch of three diamonds. That's about $4. But you know, when you're selling it, you can let them buy it as an upsell, right? You sell the corsage and they say, well, can you add some diamonds to that? And just bring them out. I say, sure. We can add these. That'd be $6.50 or $7. Oh yeah, love that. Let's add that. You know, years ago when I was at Touch of Glass, whenever it came to prom season, we put out what we would call the corsage bar, right? And everything's out there. And the brides would pick out the girls would pick out their prom corsages or boutonnieres, and then they would just add whatever they wanted. So maybe this corsage by itself is just $25. But by the time they added all these little bling to it, you had $50 corsage. So instead of being kind of a pain in the neck to make corsages, because back then we used to have to wire and tape everything, right? Today you can just glue it as fast and easy. But you can make it a real profit center for the week. So anyway, just to show you that. Just a little bit. Once again, using the calla. So nowadays, I think the brides look at the calla as a very majestic flower, a very majestic bouquet. And we see a lot of this, longer stems, almost that scepter look. I think the more confident bride today, she wants something. She wants something for her money. She wants value. And when you add the stems with the flowers, now that's worth $100, right? Not just this. So it gives her more to have. Nice finish with polka dot ribbon. And I love the padded texture with the berries. And then a little bit of the white peonies mixed in. So peonies, calla, two beautiful flowers that every bride today wants to make. Alright, these are, I love these vases. And I did that peach segment, which you only saw for like a minute, Tim. I used the gold pearl in this vase and that tall arrangement. So when you see it over there, take a look at it. They're very heavy. You know, one of the complaints I get, and it's not a complaint against us, or it's just what happens. You sell that glass, right, and the cylinder glass, and you sell a 36-inch cylinder glass, and then you go to pick it up, and three of them have been knocked over and broken, and you can't, you know, maybe you pick it up and it's okay, but the young kids that are repacking it for you don't do it right. Six of them are broken, and it's very, very expensive. But this is about the same cost, about $64 first cost. But it's a heavy metal. So even if that knucklehead driver knocks it over, you're not going to hurt it, right? And it comes in the silver and the gold. And what a great finish and great look. And then we just take, it's just a 6-inch loamy container that sits right at the mouth of that. Very well done. And you could use a 9-inch if you want. It says really nice weight. It's heavy. You just have to center it a little better than I did with this one. And Kim has used some of the David has, John used some of the crystals hanging down to give a little bit of movement and soften up the heaviness of the container. But a lot of the succulents, you know, again, that's what we're seeing. Succulents and texture. Maybe Air Fern, Dusty Miller, a little bit of looks like a short vibram and then well done. But just a mixture of those textures. The nice thing about these, and again, these are in a clearance section over there on that table, just outside the door. You could easily put two nice pillars in the center of that, and have a lot of light reflecting out in the dimness. Of course, not here on this beautiful day. By the way, thank you all very much for coming today, because on this beautiful day, I don't know if I would be here if I didn't have to be. Although we have a lot of beautiful things to show you at home. But yesterday, as I was golfing in the afternoon, I go, it's just going to be me, Dave, and Kim, and so I'm glad to be here. But anyway, this beautiful container, it's just something a little bit different, right? It's something that you can put anything on top. You can put a nice ivy plant on top if you want to just use it for an entranceway. You can put another floor plant on top of it, or a beautiful arrangement or two, just to show them off. But the metal has nice cuts in it, a nice finish, will reflect the light very nicely. It almost looks like it was lit up. Isn't that right? Orchid plants. Oh, Lordy. We sell so many orchid plants today. I never would have thought it was possible. But Bill and Alex's orchid plants are very common. And they work well, right? This is an artificial one that David has used. Take a little bit of orchid forage, plop in a couple of stems, do some branching, a little bit more of that. She's using